Hello, you've got a screenshot that I'm going to show you the results of my light bulb camera recordings from 8 p.m. On the 7th, and I took it out about 6:15 on the 8th. So let's go to it and see my memory card. And let's see, we'll go to right here is my memory card and records. That's where the files are stored. And right here, the times don't match up. There's about 6 hours difference. That's showing 159. And the way this works is 2022 is the year, the 11th month, 6 day for 06, and 2000 hours, which is 8 p.m. on the 6th yesterday, and it goes all the way down to November 11th, the 7th month, the 7th day, well, no, 11th month, 7th day, and the 7th hour. So that's 7 p.m. Okay, so that's when I stopped and pulled the memory card out. Let's go to the beginning right here, and I'm going to let you see what we get. Those are the files that it recorded, and I have it on motion detection and only capturing when it sees motion and not everything. So this reads out at that would be 8:53 and 41 minutes. 18 seconds is that file. So let's open it up. And actually, I'm going to open it up in a different player because I can control the movement of the slider bar and go back and forth, whereas the media player Windows doesn't do it. So to add files, I go over there, and this is the one that I want to. Let's see, let me make sure I get right here. Open it up, and I'm going to open up the first one right here. This is the first one, and we'll open her right there, and it starts recording right here. That's when I started, put the memory card in blank, and there's the time. And the light bulb camera is the one that's actually videoing me. And there's the timeline right there. And here's a close-up of me right there at the beginning. And when you start playing it, you see it washes out if you're too close to it. Okay, let me close that out. And the way I'm going to show you how I quickly watch this. So what you do is you bring your player up like that, and then I come over here and I hit my control button and click on each one of these, and then all I have to do is just drag them up there and let them plop in, minimize this, and there's all of them in order, and then I hit the play button here. And then I click on this, and now if I want, I can grab this and move it to see any movement. Now, obviously, there's movement there. When it goes to the end, it's going to go to the next video. And there I am. If I want to go to the end, because I know this, and then I can go to the end again. And that's my garage light lighting up the area there. There's a car went by, and I can go like this, and I can back up. So what I'm doing is looking for movement. Now, right now is not a good time to do that, so I'm just going to keep on going. Notice my shadow, and I can go over here and keep on going. Now I close the garage door, and it's 8:58 right now. These are 1 minute segments. This was actually 5 minutes or 8 minutes. No, 12. Okay, now you see there's a car coming. So I can just grab this, and I can see if there's anything else. Then I go to the next one, and then I can drag this along. See, there's nothing going on right there. But this is how you can do it quickly. And then right here. Okay, now what it did is went back around to the beginning. See, it's highlighted. So when it gets to the end, it goes back around and it didn't start playing. You notice that? There's the file name. So I'm at the end. Okay, to clear that out, and then I can go to the next hour, and we're going to go to one more hour to let you see something. Okay, I go back to records, and now I can pick the hours. This was 8, 9, 10, 11. This is midnight right here. Let's see what's going on in our neighborhood at midnight. I click on it, and these are the files that were captured. Now, I hit my control, go through and highlight each one of these, and then go down, push it again. Now, all of them are highlighted. Now, I can just hit open, and they'll all appear in there. That starts playing, so I could stop it. Then you have to go over here in the lower left, click it, and it'll come up big. And I can make it large, like this, if I want. And then, if I want to quickly see what's going on in there, I can move this like that to look for, oh, see those little bugs? Right there's a bug leaving a tail. Now, when I start playing, notice it goes to the next. Now, I can just go over here and click, and it'll go to the next one. And right here's the file names, and they start like this, 37 minutes. Now watch, it'll go to the next 38 or 39, 38. Now I can grab it again and look and see if I see any movement. Nope. And here I can grab it again and just move it fast. So you can go through a lot of video real quick. Ah, right there, something going on. And I can move it back and forth to see if I see anything that I want to remember, and it'll go to the next one. Now I can, if I want, just speed through it by clicking at the end like that. Okay, and I might miss something that way, so I can just sit here with it paused or not playing, and you can see things that are going on. Play, and now we're up to, now if I want to see where I'm at, that's 1 minute after midnight. And so what I can do is I need to bring this back down. I can go over here to this arrow on the left, and it'll take me and show me I've started over, and now I'm back on the second one. So let me go to 4 o'clock in the morning, because there's something happened at about 56 minutes after 4. So let me find that file. Now, I can easily find it by going to records, and now I'm going to look for 4 o'clock in the morning right here. See? So I double click on that, and here are the files, and I want to go to 46 minutes, actually 45 minutes, because that'll carry into 46. Open her up, and then go here, and then I'm going to make it large by clicking on that, and now I'm going to move the slider and see if I see something. Oh, look what happens right there. Look at, what is that? It's an armadillo, I'm sure, so let me let it play from that point. Now watch him on the left-hand side, scooting around right there. And he's right in the runway. I mean, he don't walk in the grass. He likes walking on the street, and that was the end of him. Okay. And this is the same one again, because I only clicked on that one. Okay, so I can get back to normal, and then I can go back to my files. So, see, I only had one file, so you got to put list of files there that you want to see. I just thought you might want to see how you can look at your photos quickly. And let me clear that, and let me go to a more adventurous time period, like in here about 9 o'clock at night. So let's go to 9 o'clock. So I go to the records, and remember that's 8, 9 right here. We're a 55 and over community, and this is a lot of traffic, I thought, for our little community. So let me just share it with you. So I'm going to load all of these into the player and just kind of let you see how I can speed through the night. And that's what I'm interested in, seeing while I'm sleeping. I want to see what's going on in my neighborhood. This is the way to do it. The daytime, this would not be interesting at all because there's so much traffic. Now I hit OK. Now it puts everything in there and it defaults to the top and starts playing it. I click if I want to pause it. Then I can sit here and look at what's going on and see the car right there. Looks like a truck, and keep on going. Now we'll hit play, and now I'm going to speed through them. And the way I do it, just grab it, nothing happened there, and there, and see, I can pause and see the time. That was at 21 is 9. That's actually 10 o'clock at night. 22, 23, yes. That's 10:04, a car went by right there. Okay, let's go on. And I hit play, and now I'm going to go through the next one. The next one. Notice down here, these are the files that are coming up. Oh, look at here. Now, at 10:09, one of my neighbors is walking her dog. And this captured her walking in front of the place. So the camera is able to capture movement pretty good. And small items. I don't think that armadillo was captured by movement. He just happened to be at the time it was being recorded. And you can see it just keeps on going. And going around the bend, that's a cul-de-sac. Okay, and here's another car. And that was 10 minutes after 10. And then I'll go over here. This is 11 minutes after. And see how fast I can look through this and see where stuff is happening. Even though I have the camera on motion only, I get other stuff, and it may be bugs setting it off. I don't know exactly what. But there you see what's going on. You just grab it and you can slide it pretty fast. So you can even just go to the end. And if you don't see some movement right away, there was some movement, more movement, and nothing. And see, I can break it up and go at quicker times like this. I can go there, there, and there, and capture a lot in that area. And then if I just want to quickly, there's something going on, and just move on. So you can go through the night in 30 minutes or so. You can see what happened using this method. And so that's the value of the camera, what you can see. And go back, and there's everything we did. I can clear it, and I can put some more files in here. And when you add files, you just go to your records and then pick the folder. If you want, like, let's go to that last when I turned it off and see if it captures me doing that. Okay, so there's only 3 files. This one right here was probably the last one that probably is going to show it. Let's see if I am in there. Nope. 7. Let me see, I have to go over. Oh. Yeah, let me go back to add files. And I want to do this one. Let's try this one. This one. And open those in there. Okay, let's try this. Okay. There's somebody coming. And there's the next one. Okay. Now, you see what this is my garage door opened, and there's the light from my garage door. And let's see if I come out. Okay, it didn't capture it there. It's actually about 7:15. So there must be some delay in, this was 6:59. It didn't show me. I noticed that there's a little delay between the time it actually captures it and it records it onto the memory card. So I think that's the delay why I didn't get it. Okay, that's what we have. And that's what you get without the internet connected. These videos are all done without the internet. The camera is just sitting up there. I can move it by hand, but I can't control it, because I'm not using the app or the Wi-Fi. It's just sitting out there recording, and it's not recording all of the time. It's recording motion. So that's why you see in the wee morning hours, like 4 o'clock, there's fewer recordings than like at 8 or 9 o'clock at night. Okay, so there you go. Oh, let me let you just see what 8 o'clock looks like. Let's see. Go over here. And this was 8 o'clock at night. Well, that's not very many. Yeah. But I have seen it where it's more. Let's see. This is... that's a lot more. At 9 o'clock. That's 9 o'clock. Let's go to 8 o'clock didn't. Okay, let's go to 10 o'clock. About the same as 9, quite a bit. But if you notice, 8 o'clock had just a few. So that's what you can expect when you pull the memory card out and put it in your computer and use the media player on your Windows-based computer and not Windows Media Player. Windows Media Player doesn't allow you to pull the scroll bar across to speed through the video. Okay. Well, there you go, folks. I hope this helps you with your light bulb camera, and so get out there and enjoy it and watch some of that video early in the morning and see what you capture.